Hello, my dear students of class 9. So, after a long time, we are back again. We will do lesson number 1, Father's Health by R.K. Narayan. This is your class 10. This is your class 10's book, okay? And it is the first chapter that you will be getting. When you get the book, you will go through it. I will not complete all the chapters very fast. I'll go it very slow. So that when you get the book, you will get the idea of the chapters. So listen to it. Just listen. And if you can see the video, please do follow the lines. So R.K. Narayan, 1906-2001, is one of the leading figures of early Indian literature in English. His notable works include Malgudi Days and The Guide. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in 1958 for The Guide. It can come in your question. So Sahitya Academy Award in 1958 for The Guide. The story. So what is the story about? We will get a gist of it, as we always get through these blue lines. The story, an edited excerpt from Malgudi Days. So the whole story, the story that we are going to get, we have got it from Malgudi Days. It's about a young boy called Swaminathan who is unwilling to go to school. It's a basic thing. We have all also read Tom Sawyer, that he was he was not very friendly with the school's environment, and he wanted to skip the Monday school, but is forced by his father to attend the school. The school explores how, through the events that follow, Swami's original reservations about his teacher, Samuel, get transformed considerably. So, as we go through the chapter, you'll be able to understand what this blue line says. Lying in bed, Swami realized with a shudder that it was Monday morning. It looked as though only a moment ago it was Friday. Already Monday was there. Here, he hoped he didn't have to go to school. So, lying in bed, Swami realized with a shudder, means with a surprise, that it was Monday. I have to go to school and it is Monday. I don't want to go to school. So, it looked as though only a moment ago it was Friday. So, he was so asleep and he was dreaming that it was Friday and not Monday. And the Friday have covered so fast and the Monday have arrived. So already Monday was here. He hoped he didn't have to go to school. At 9 o'clock, Swaminathan wailed. Wailed means shouted, "I have a headache. Oh, my head is paining." Mother generously suggested that Swami might stay at home. Mothers are always very kind-hearted, not rigid as fathers. So mother genuinely says that, "Okay, beta, you stay at home. Don't have to go to school." So at 9:30, when he ought to have been in school prayer hall, means he was supposed to be at 9:30, he was supposed to be where? At the school's prayer hall. But instead of that, Swami was lying on the bench in mother's room. So these things are very important. Follow the lines, okay? Swami was lying where? On the bench in mother's room. So it can come as true or false where? It says in the question, if it says father's room, then you have to change those sentences by mother's room. Father asked him, "Have you no school today?" So father came in now rigid, strict father came in and he said, "Have you no school today?" "Headache," Swami replied. "Oh, my head is paining and I cannot go to school." "Nonsense. Dress up and go." So father have understood the trick that he was trying to play and he said, "Nonsense. Go, dress up and go to school. Headache. Loaf about less on Sundays and he will without a headache on Monday." So he's trying to tell his son that please do not go out, means do not wander about so much on Sundays. When you get a holiday, okay, so from Monday to Saturday you are having school, from Monday to Friday you are having school, okay, so and when you get a one day holiday, you go out of your house, enjoy a lot under the sun, so that is creating your headache. Father wants to say that. So loaf means wander about. So loaf about less on Sundays and you will be without a headache on Monday. Swami knew how strict his father could be, so he changed his tactics. So he sends his idea. I can't go so late to the class. So he's giving excuse now. He's already late, prayer is already over, and the school will not allow me to get inside the school. You'll have to. It is your own fault. So father is now forcing his son that he will have to go. Otherwise, it is your fault. You have to mend your fault. What will the teacher think if I go so late? So Swami is continuously interpreting in a very wrong way. He is telling that my teacher, what will my teacher think? That if I get so late to school, what will my teacher think? So father is telling, tell him you had a headache, so you are late. So you will tell your teacher that you are late because you had a headache. He will scold me if I say so. So he is telling that my teacher will scold me. Will he? Let us see. What is his name? Samuel. Does he always scold the students? So father is asking that, does always Samuel behave like this? So he's a very angry man. He's giving a very wrong interpretation about Samuel. He's giving a very wrong introduction about Samuel. Samuel is not a strict teacher as he is. As Swami shows. Okay. So he's giving a very wrong introduction about whom? About Swami. About Samuel. Sorry, I always get confused about Samuel and Swami. So Samuel is a teacher. And Swaminathan, you know, the boy who is escaping the school, is trying to escape the school. So does he always scold the students? He's a very angry man. He's especially angry with boys who come in late. So now another lie that he's telling, that Samuel always used to get angry when boys came in late in class. I wouldn't like to go late to Samuel's class. If he's so angry, why not tell your headmaster about it? So father is little bit of curious. So father is telling, if he's so angry, if he behaves like that, so why don't you go and tell your headmaster about it? That he's not allowing me to come to the class as I have a headache, so I had not got the chance to come before the prayer. So then they say that even the headmaster is afraid of him. So Samuel now ends the first unit by saying that Swami says that to his father that the headmaster is even afraid of Samuel. What will headmaster say to Samuel? He will not say anything to Samuel because the whole school, even the headmaster, is afraid of Samuel's personality. He's such an angry man. Shudder, shaking of body caused by fear. Loaf, move around in an idle manner. Means wander about. So the first, choose the correct alternative to complete the following sentences. I'm telling it to you. You just copy it. Do it in your book. With a shudder, Swami realized that it was Monday. Number four, Monday. When Swami ought to have been in the school prayer hall, he was lying where? He was lying on the bench. Bench. Lying on the bench. Okay, we'll do these parts. I'll give you the comprehension exercises by writing it down. Okay, so let me complete the whole things till 3. I will complete it with my classes. First, I hope you have understood unit number 1. Try to read it. There are many short questions that you will get in Duff and Duds. So buy Duff and Duds book also for your class 10 Duff and Duds book. It will be easy for you to go with the questions, that how the questions can come in your boards. Okay. So till here for today. We'll come meet again in the next class. Okay. Stay safe. Stay home. Bye bye.